Hello students, this is grade 9 physics class, chapter 8, motion. In previous video class, we have seen how does velocity changes, then what is acceleration, unit of acceleration, then whether it is vector quantity, scalar quantity, then some numericals also. Is it clear? Yes. So in this session, we are going to start our next topic. What is that? Next topic. So in order to start our next topic, you should recall, so what are the things we have seen in last video class, because it will be very helpful for you. Is it clear? Yes. So first one, how does the velocity changes? So velocity of object can be changed in three ways. Is it clear? In three ways. What are the ways? First one, if speed changes, velocity will change. First one, what is that? If speed of the object changes, velocity will change. That is first one. And second one, if the direction of the object changes, velocity will change. Am I right? Yes. Third one, what is that? If both speed and direction of the object changes, velocity will change. So, velocity of the object changes in three ways. First one, speed. If speed changes, velocity will change. And second one, if direction of the object, velocity will change. And third one, if speed and direction change, velocity will change. Is it clear? Because velocity depends on two factors. First one, speed, and second one, direction. Is it clear? Because velocity has speed as well as direction. If any one quantity changes, velocity will automatically change. Is it clear? Yes. Next one, what we have seen, that is acceleration. What is that? That is acceleration. So whenever velocity of the object changes, the new term or the new physical quantity will occur, that is acceleration. Am I right? That is acceleration. So we can say the change in acceleration per unit time. What is that? The change in acceleration per unit time, that is called acceleration. Change in velocity per unit time. Is that clear? Change in velocity per unit time, that is called acceleration. Sorry for that. The change in velocity per unit time, that is called acceleration. Is that clear? Yes, very simple. Or otherwise we can say rate of change of velocity. What is that? Rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. It's very, very simple. So whenever the velocity of the object changes, the new term will occur, that is acceleration. Is it clear? What is that? That is acceleration. It's very simple. So we can say the change in velocity per unit time, that is called acceleration. So what is the unit of acceleration, sir? The unit of acceleration, that is equal to meter per second square. What is that? Meter per second square. Because acceleration, that is equal to change in velocity divided by time taken. Am I right? So what is the velocity unit? That is meter per second. Then time, second. Is that clear? So when this denominator, which means then the second goes to numerator, it becomes meter per second square. So SI unit of acceleration, that is meter per second square. Is that clear? Yes. Next one, acceleration, whether it is vector quantity or scalar quantity. Acceleration is a vector quantity because it has both magnitude as well as direction. Is it clear? Because acceleration is depend on velocity. Am I right? So velocity is a vector quantity. Okay, just velocity changes. Here in acceleration, just velocity changes. Is it clear? But it has both magnitude as well as direction. So the acceleration is under the category of the vector quantity. Is it clear? What is that? Vector quantity. So what is the mathematical formula? What is that? Mathematical formula for acceleration. Acceleration, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. That is mathematical formula. Okay. So most of the numerical cases, we are going to use this formula. Is it clear? Yes. So acceleration, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity, that is divided by time taken. Is it clear? Yes. That is a mathematical formula for acceleration. The acceleration symbol, small a. Next one, final velocity symbol, that is small b. Next, initial velocity symbol, small u, and divided by time taken symbol, that is t. So we can get a, that is equal to, which means small a, which is equal to v minus u divided by t. Is it clear? What is that? V minus u divided by t, that is acceleration. Is it clear? So very, very simple, so don't get confusion. So still now we have seen up to this. Is it clear? So what is acceleration? A change in velocity per unit time. What is that? Change in velocity per unit time. What is per unit time, sir? Which means how much velocity changes per second. Okay. How much velocity of the object changes per second that is acceleration. Is it clear? So very, very simple, so don't get confused. Okay, so next, in this session, we are going to start our next topic, that is uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration or non-uniform acceleration and so many things. Okay, let's get started. First, we will see uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. Yes, next topic, that is uniform acceleration. First one, what is that? Uniform acceleration. Look at here. Here the title reveals the answer. Is it clear? So what is acceleration? The changes in velocity. Okay, velocity changes per unit time. That is acceleration. Am I right? Look at here. So here, velocity changes uniformly. Look at here. So change in velocity per unit time, that is acceleration, we know very well clearly. So velocity changes in uniform rate. Okay, which means uniformly. That is uniform acceleration. Is it clear? That is uniform acceleration. So in uniform acceleration, the velocity just changes uniformly. Velocity changes uniformly, is it clear? So that is uniform acceleration. So already we know whenever velocity changes, a new term will occur, that is acceleration. So here, velocity of the object changes uniformly. Is it clear? So that is uniform acceleration. Is it clear? So very simple. So let's get started. Let's start with an example to understand the concept of uniform acceleration. Is it clear? Yes. First, consider a straight road. This is straight road. The length of a straight road shows only one direction. Okay, only one, which means a particular direction. Is it clear? Yes. Next, consider a car. Okay, first look at here. Consider a straight road. The length of a straight road shows only one direction, which means which specifies particular direction. Is it clear? Yes. So if the length of the road shows particular direction, what is that? That is displacement. Is it clear? Yes. Next, consider a car. This is a car. Consider a car. Initially, the car is at rest. What is that? Initially, the car is at rest. So I am going to ask one question. So what is the initial velocity of that car? The initial velocity of that car is zero. Am I right? Initial velocity of the car, zero. Why, sir? Why initial velocity of the car? Car zero, then the car at rest. Why, sir? What happens? Is it clear? Yes. So already we know, what is velocity? What is the velocity? The rate of change of displacement, that is velocity. Am I right? Here, what is the displacement covered by the object? Here, the displacement covered by the object, zero, which means the car zero. So, if the displacement zero, then the velocity becomes zero. Which means that car doesn't change its position. Car doesn't ever change, so displacement zero. If the displacement zero, then initial velocity becomes zero. Is it clear? Yes. So, initial velocity that is equal to 0 meter per second. Okay, or you can use 0. Is it clear? Yes. Look at here. At point A, the car's initial velocity is 0. Where? At point A. Note this point. At point A, the car initial velocity is 0. Is it clear? Very, very simple. I repeat it. Consider a straight road, then consider a car, that is object here. So initially, that car is at rest at position A. Can you see position A? Yes, this is position A. So initial velocity of the car is zero, because displacement zero. If the displacement zero, then velocity becomes zero. Is it clear? So the initial velocity of the car is zero. Is it clear? Yes, very simple. Now look at here. Next, the car starts moving. What is that? Here, the car starts moving. Is it clear? Yes. Gradually, the car velocity changes. Is it clear? What is point? Very important one. The car's velocity gradually increases. Okay? Yes. Next,
at 50 seconds, at 15 seconds, at 15 seconds, the car velocity changes, which means the car attains the velocity or reaches the velocity of 10 meters per second. How much? 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Look at here. Initially, the car is at rest. Okay, so initial velocity is zero. Am I right?
Yes.
Here, the car starts moving. So, the car velocity is gradually increases. Is it clear? Car velocity gradually increases. At 15 seconds, how much? What is the time here? At 15 seconds, the car reaches the velocity of 10 meters per second. What is that? 10 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now, I am going to ask a question. Here, what is initial velocity and what is final velocity? Look at here. Here, which is initial velocity? This is initial velocity. So, here, initial velocity of the car is 0. Then, what is the final velocity? What is the final velocity? Then, in the time of 15 seconds, that is 10 meters per second. Am I 10 meters per second? So, 0 meter per second, that is initial velocity of the car. Then, 10 meters per second, that is final velocity of the car. After 15 seconds, the time taken how much? 15 seconds. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now, what is the difference? What is the difference between the velocity? Two velocity. So, final velocity minus initial velocity. What is that? Acceleration. Am I right? So, final velocity minus initial velocity. If you subtract both, if you minus both, we can get the change in velocity. Am I right? We can get the change in velocity. Is it clear? Yes, how much? So final velocity 10 meters per second, then initial velocity 0 meter per second. So 10 meters per second minus 0 meters per second, that is equal to 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. Is it clear? So very, very simple. So look at here. Consider point A. At point A, the car is at rest, so initial velocity 0. Is it clear? Then the car speed gradually increases. At 15 seconds, time how much? At 15 seconds, first 15 seconds, the car reaches the velocity of 10 meters per second. How much? 10 meters per second. So now the car comes to position B. This is position B. Is it clear?
Yes.
So here the velocity of a car increases. So velocity increases from 0 meters per second into 10 meters per second. Am I right? The velocity of the car increases. So there is change in velocity. Am I right? Here there is some change in velocity. Here the velocity of the car changes from 0 meters per second into 10 meters per second. Am I right? So what is the change in velocity? So if we minus from final velocity to initial velocity, we can get that change. That is equal to how much? 10 meters per second. How much? 10 meters per second. So the velocity of the car increases at the rate of 10 meters per second in 15 seconds, first 15 seconds. Am I right?
Yes.
Look at it. Next one, from the point B, note this point. From the point B, here the car velocity again increases. Is it clear? So, next 15 seconds, the car attains the velocity of 20 meters per second from the point B. So now what is the car's velocity? That is 20 meters per second from the point. What is the time? Given next 15 seconds. So time 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Is it clear? Now consider car at position B. What is the velocity of the car? 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Next 15 seconds. What is the time? Your next 15 seconds, the car reaches the velocity of 20 meters per second. Okay, from the point B. Is it clear? From the point B. Is it clear? So now the car velocity how much? 20 meters per second in next 15 seconds. Is it clear? Next 15 seconds. Is it clear?
Yes.
Next, I'm going to ask the question. Here, which is final velocity and which is initial velocity? So, this is final velocity of the car. Alright, this is final velocity of the car and this is initial velocity of the car. Is it clear?
Yes.
Because here, car velocity changes from the point B. From the point, initially from here. Then after 15 seconds, the car velocity changes from the point B, you leave it this part, you consider this part. You leave that part, you leave it that part, you consider this one. Is it clear? So from the point B, the car velocity changes at the rate of 20 meters per second. Time taken how much? Even next 15 minutes. So time taken 15 seconds. Is it clear? Yes. So here, this is initial velocity and that is final velocity. So what is the change in velocity? So already we know change in velocity, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. Here which is final velocity? 20 meters per second, that is final velocity. Then 10 meters per second, that is initial velocity. So 20 meters per second minus 10 meters per second, that is equal to how much? That is equal to 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. So what is the change in velocity? Change in velocity, that is equal to 10 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Next one. So what is the time difference? Look at here. What is the time difference? So what is the time difference? So initially, the time, initially which means at rest, what is the time? Time 0. Okay, but time never be 0. You consider as 0 here. Okay, time never be 0. Is it clear? So you consider as 0. Is it clear? Then first 15 seconds, the velocity changes at the rate of 10 meters per second. So what is the time difference between A point A and B? That is 15 seconds. Am I right?
Yes.
Here, 15 seconds. So first 15 seconds, the car velocity changes at the rate of 10 meters per second. Am I right?
Yes.
Now consider this point. Consider the point B and C. This is point C. What is the time difference between the two points? Between the point B and C. Here, look at here. Time difference 30 seconds minus 15 seconds is equal to 15 seconds. That is equal to how much? 15 seconds. Is it clear?
Yes.
Look at here. Now the car is at position C. Now car is at position C. Is it clear? Next. Next 15 seconds, even next 15 seconds, which means so 30 seconds plus 15 seconds, how much? 45 seconds. Look at here, from the point C, here the car velocity changes, how much? Look at here, the car velocity changes at the rate of 30 meters per second. The car velocity changes how much? 30 meters per second. So in next 15 seconds, how much in next 15 seconds? Is it clear?
Yes.
Look at here, consider point B, sorry, point C, this is point C. From the point C, the car velocity again changes. The car velocity changes at the rate of 30 meter per second from this point C. Is it clear? So next, the time taken, next 15 seconds. Is it clear? Here, consider these two points, the point C and this is point B. Point C and point B, is it clear? Here, what is the change in velocity? The change in velocity, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. Is it clear? Here, which is final velocity and which is initial velocity? This is initial velocity. 20 meters per second, that is initial velocity, and 30 meters per second, that is final velocity. So, final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to what is that? Change in velocity. Am I right? Because velocity here increases. Is it clear?
Yes.
So, the change in velocity, how much? 30 meters per second minus 20 meters per second. That is equal to 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Next one, what is the time difference between the two velocities, two changing velocities? So this there is already 30 seconds and here 45 seconds. Am I right? So 45 seconds minus 30 seconds is equal to 15 seconds. Time 15 seconds. 15 seconds. Is it clear? Very, very simple. Don't get confused. Now the car at position D here. Now the car at position D. Is it clear? So look at here. So from the point D, again the car velocity changes. Is it clear?
Even
next 15 seconds. How much? Next 15 seconds. So the velocity time, how much? 60 seconds. Okay, so next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 40 meters per second. 40 meters per second. Is it clear? So from the point D. Already what is the velocity of the car? That is 30 meters per second. Is it clear? Even next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 40 meters per second. How much? 40 meters per second. So here, velocity of the car increases. Our velocity of the car increase. So here, which is final velocity and which is initial velocity? You tell me that. Point D, that is initial velocity, and point E, this is point E, that is final velocity. Am I right? So that is change in velocity. So change in velocity, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. So final velocity is 40 meters per second and initial velocity is 30 meters per second. So 40 meters per second minus 30 meters per second is equal to how much? That is equal to 10 meters per second. So the change in velocity, which means the difference in velocity for the two term, that is 10 meters per second. Is it clear? 10 meters per second. It's very, very simple. Don't get confused. Okay. Then what is the time difference? What is the time difference between the point D and E? That is, so 60 seconds minus 40 per second, that is equal to how much? 15 seconds. 15 seconds. Is it clear? Yes. So what did you understand from this concept? What did you understand? What did you understand? Look at here. Look at here, very simple. Here, velocity of the car. Here, velocity of the car increases in equal amount by in equal interval of time. In equal interval of time. Is it clear? So time counts. Time 15 seconds, 15 seconds, 15 seconds, 15 seconds. Is it clear? Your velocity of the car also increases in equal amount, that is 10 meters per second, 10 meters per second, 10 meters per second, 10 meters per second. Is it clear? So velocity of the car increases by equal amounts. How much? 10 meters per second in equal interval of time. How much time? In 15 seconds. So then the motion is said to be uniformly accelerated motion. So this is called uniform acceleration. Is it clear? This is called uniform acceleration. So whenever an object velocity increases by equal amount in equal interval of time, then the motion is called uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. So very, very simple. Don't get confusion. Is it clear? Look at here. I will repeat it. It's a very, very important one. So consider a straight road. Consider a car. Initially, the car is at rest. At the point A, the car is at rest. So initial velocity of the car, 0 meters per second. Is it clear? Initial velocity of the car, 0 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Here, the car starts moving. So the gradually the car speed increases, which means the velocity increases. So at 15 seconds, look at here, at 15 seconds, the car reaches the velocity of 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second, is it clear? So here the car velocity increases from 0 meter per second into 10 meters per second in 15 seconds. Time how much? In 15 seconds. Am I right? Yes. So there is change in velocity. Am I right? There is change in velocity. Here, there is change in velocity. So change in velocity, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. Here, which is final velocity? 10 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 0 meter per second, that is initial velocity. So 10 meters per second minus 0 meters per second, that is equal to 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes, very simple. Yes. Now consider point B. So now the car comes to point B. From the point B, what this point very important? Not from A, from this point B. Is it clear? So from this point B, again the car velocity increases. How much? Again the car velocity increases. So next, what is point? Next 15 seconds. So already at the point A, point B, what is the time? 15 seconds. So from the point, at next 15 seconds, the car velocity increases at the rate of 20 meters per second. How much? 20 meters per second. What is the time here? Time 30 seconds. So already at point B, 15 seconds. So 30 seconds minus 15 seconds is equal to 15 seconds. So time interval how much? 15 seconds. Is it clear? Now consider these two points, point B and point C. So what is the velocity of the car at point C, that is 20 meters per second, and point B, that is 10 meters per second. So velocity of the car changes from point B to point C. Okay, which means velocity of the car changes from 10 meters per second into 20 meters per second. So here, which is final velocity and which is initial velocity? 20 meters per second, this is final velocity and 10 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right? So final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to 10 meters per second. Am I right? So here, in next 15 seconds also, the car velocity changes how much? Same 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Same 10 meters per second. Is it clear? It's very simple. Now consider the point C. You leave it. You leave it in solve. Now consider the point C, which means the car at point C. Is it clear? So already what is the car velocity at point C? That is 20 meters per second. Am I right? 20 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. So now the car at position C. So from the point C, look at here. From the point C, again the car velocity changes, which means again the car velocity increases. Is it clear? Yes. So next 15 second, what is that? Next 15 second, the car velocity changes to 30 meters per second. What is that? 30 meters per second from 20 meters per second. Is it clear? So what is the time taken? Time taken same. So 45 seconds minus 30 seconds, that is 15 seconds. Is it clear? Yes. Now consider the 2 points, point C and point D. Here which is final velocity and which is initial velocity. So this is final velocity. Am I right? 30 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 20 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Is it clear? Because the car speed increases from this point, from C. So from C, at position C already the car velocity 20 meters per second. Is it clear? So there is some change in velocity. That change in velocity is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. So final velocity 30 meters per second and initial velocity 20 meters per second, which is equal to 10 meters per second. So the change in velocity how much? 10 meters per second. Even next 15 seconds or so, the car velocity changes at the rate of 10 meters per second. How much? 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Now the car comes to position D. Now the car comes to position D. Is it clear? So already what is the velocity at the point of D? 30 meters per second. The car velocity 30 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. From the point D, what is this point? From the point D, again the car velocity increases. Again the car velocity increases. So after 15 seconds, time how much? Time save. After 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 40 meters per second. How much? 40 meters per second. Is it clear? What is the time taken? Time remains same. Time, that is same, that is 15 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. So now the car comes to position E. Position E. Here, consider these two terms, point D and point D. Point D and point E. Here, which is final velocity and which is initial velocity? See, E is a final velocity and D is a initial velocity. So final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to change in velocity. Am I right? Yes. So 40 meters per second minus 30 meters per second, which is equal to 10 meters per second. So how much velocity changes? 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. But time remains same. Time remains same. So listen here, come to the concept. Here, velocity of the car increases. So velocity of the car increases by equal amounts in equal interval of time. Am I right? Equal amounts in equal interval of time. So this is called uniform acceleration. Is it clear? Is it clear? That is called uniform acceleration. Okay, because here velocity changes. So whenever changes, whenever velocity changes, there will be another quantity, that is acceleration. Is it clear? Yes. So here velocity changes, that is equal amounts in equal interval of time. So that's why it is called uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. So whenever an object velocity changes by equal amounts, what is that? By equal amounts in equal interval of time, we can say that is uniform acceleration. Is it clear? That is uniform acceleration. Then the motion is said to be uniformly accelerated motion. What is that? Uniformly accelerated motion. So very, very simple. You don't get confusion. Is it clear? Yes. Okay, look at here. The velocity changes 10 meters per second, 10 meters per second, 10 meters per second, 10 meters per second. Velocity is uniformly increasing. Is it clear? Uniformly increasing. Even time also how much? 15 seconds, 15 seconds, 15 seconds, 15 seconds. Time remains same. So, in equal interval of time, the velocity of the object changes equally. Is it clear? Which means uniformly. So, that is called uniform acceleration. What is that? that motion is called uniform acceleration, then the body is said to be uniformly accelerated motion. Very simple. Is it clear? So finally, come to the content, concept. What is the concept? So if the velocity of the object increases, if the velocity of the body or object increases by equal amounts in equal interval of time, then the motion is said to be uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. You note down in your classroom notes, very, very important content, this one. Is it clear? So this is an example for uniform acceleration motion. Okay. Next, I'm going to make a tabular column. Okay, I'm going to make a tabular column to find in uniform accelerated motion, the acceleration will be constant. Is it clear? The acceleration will be constant. You look at here. So I'm going to rub this. I'm going to make a table around. Look at here. First one, velocity. Second one, time. Third one, acceleration. Third one, what is that? Acceleration. So what is the initial velocity of the car? At point A, that is 0 meters per second. What is the time? At the time nil, which means 0, time level is 0, you consider as nil, which means 0. Then 10 meters per second, 20 meters per second, 30 meters per second, then 40 meters per second. So this is the increasing rate of the velocity of the car. Alright. Then what is the time? 15 seconds, 30 seconds, 45 seconds, then 60 seconds. The time remains same. Is it clear? Now find out the acceleration. Acceleration that is equal to how much? What is acceleration formula? Final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. Am I right? Yes. Look at here. Acceleration that is equal to, what is that? Acceleration that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. Am I right? Final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. That is acceleration. Am I right? Yes. Now I am going to prove in uniform acceleration, the acceleration value will be constant. Okay, that means that is remain same. Is it clear?
Yes.
Here, first take two change in velocity, two terms. Okay, here which is final velocity, which is initial velocity. 10 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 0, that is initial velocity. All right. So what is that? At acceleration, final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. Is it clear?
Yes.
Here, which is final velocity, which is initial velocity. 10 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 0 meters per second, that is initial velocity. What is the change in velocity? That is equal to 10 meters per second. Am I right? 10 meters per second. You substitute here, final velocity how much? 10 meters per second minus initial velocity. So I will write clearly, look at here. Acceleration is equal to V minus U divided by T. So final velocity how much? 10 meters per second. Initial velocity how much? 0 meters per second divided by time taken how much? Time difference how much? 15 seconds. Just 15 seconds. This is equal to how much? You will do this. So 10 meters per second divided by 15 seconds. How much? 10 by 15? So 10 divided by 15 how much? The smallest number around 0. Then 6, 15, 90. 6 into 15, that is 90, and remaining 10, and again add 1 0, we can get the same 100, so 6, that is equal to 90. So what is the value? Acceleration value that is equal to 0.66 meter per second square. How much? The acceleration value, 0.66 meter per second square, at the interval of, okay, at the change velocity of 0 meter per second minus, 10 meters per second minus 0 meter per second. Is it clear? For first one. Next, you take the second two parts like this. Second two parts. So here, which is final velocity, which is initial velocity? 20 meters per second, that is final velocity. And 10 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right? So what is the change in velocity? So final velocity minus initial velocity. So 20 meters per second minus 10 meters per second, that is equal to 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
So again, find the acceleration. Acceleration b minus u divided by t. So final velocity how much? 10 meters per second minus initial velocity 10 meters per second divided by time taken how much? What is the time difference between both? 30 seconds minus 15 seconds. That is 15 seconds. So time value how much? Time remains same. 15 seconds. So which is equal to how much? 10 meters per second minus 20 meters per second minus 10 meters per second. That is equal to 10 meters per second. So it is equal to 10 meters per second divided by 15 seconds. So already we know this 10 by 15 is equal to how much? That is equal to 0.66 meter per second square. 0.66 meter per second square. Next you take next two terms. Take like this. Okay, take the velocity, change in velocity is equal to 30 meters per second minus 20 meters per second. So what is change in velocity? That is equal to 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Now find out the acceleration. So v minus u divided by t. Final velocity 30 meters per second. 30 meters per second minus initial velocity 20 meters per second divided by time taken how much? Time difference 15 seconds. The same 15 seconds. Yes, 15 seconds. This is equal to how much? 30 meters per second minus 20 meters per second. This is equal to 10 meters per second divided by 15 seconds. So already we know what is the 10 meters per second divided by 15 meters per 50 second. That is equal to 0.66 meter per second square. 0.66 meter per second square. Is it clear? Next, to take last two terms, which means the change in velocity between 30 meters per second and 40 meters per second. So what is the change in velocity? 40 meters per second minus 30 meters per second, which is equal to how much? 10 meters per second. What is that? 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. So now find out the acceleration. Yes, it is equal to v minus u divided by t. That is the acceleration formula. Then final velocity how much? 40 meters per second. 40 meters per second. Initial velocity 30 meters per second. 30 meters per second. And divided by time taken. Time difference how much? 15 seconds. Time same. 15 seconds. Which is equal to how much? 40 meters per second minus 30 meters per second. Which is equal to 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second divided by 15 seconds. So already we know 10 meters per second divided by 15 seconds is equal to 0.66 meter per second square. 0.66 meter per second square. Look at here. In uniformly accelerated motion, the acceleration value will be constant. Is it clear? Because in uniform acceleration, the velocity of the object increases uniformly. Is it clear? Velocity of the object increases uniformly. So the acceleration will be constant. Look at here. In first case, the first time acceleration 0.66 meter per second square. Even here, second also 0.66 meter per second. Even here, third one, even fourth one also. Okay, so if you take whatever the velocity changes, the acceleration will be remain same. So clear, the acceleration will be remain same, that is equal to 0.66 meter per second square. So in uniform acceleration, look at here, mark my word. In uniform acceleration, the acceleration will be same. The acceleration value will be same, which means that is constant. It never change. Is it clear? So very, 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 very important. Why, sir? Why the acceleration constant here? Because in uniform acceleration, the velocity of the object increases equal amounts. What is that? Equal amount in equal interval of time. Time same as well as velocity change is also same. So here acceleration value will be constant. Look at here, acceleration value is constant here. Every point, if you take any change in velocity, the acceleration remains same. That is remains constant. Am I right? So very, very important. So don't get confused. Okay, so finally conclude that what is uniform acceleration? So when an object velocity increases, note this point, when an object velocity increases by equal amounts in equal interval of time, is it clear? Equal interval of time, then the motion is called uniform acceleration motion. Is it clear? Then the motion is called uniform acceleration. Then the body is said to be uniformly accelerated motion.
Body said to be uniformly accelerated motion, so very very important. So in uniform acceleration, the acceleration remains constant. Is it clear? In uniform acceleration, the acceleration value will be constant. It never changes. Is it clear? Yes. Very very simple. So don't get confused. Okay. Yes. Next one, I'll give some examples for this uniform acceleration. Okay, examples for uniform acceleration. Examples for uniform acceleration. Is it clear? First one example, the motion of a ball rolling down an inclined plane. The motion of a ball rolling down an inclined plane. Okay, first example for the uniform acceleration, that is the motion of a ball. What is that? The motion of a ball rolling down an inclined plane. What is that? Inclined plane. Okay, consider an inclined plane. You know what is inclined plane? Inclined plane is nothing but there is a slanting surface. What is that? Slanting surface, that is inclined plane. Is it clear? So this is inclined plane and this is ground. That is ground. Okay? So consider a inclined plane. This is inclined surface. This point inclined surface and that is ground. Is it clear? Yes. Next, consider a ball. This is ball. Consider a ball. That ball is at top. Where? At top of the inclined plane. Is it clear? Consider a ball. This is ball. That ball is at rest at top. Where? At top of an inclined surface. Is it clear? Which means consider you are holding that ball. Is it clear? Yes. If you release the ball from top of an inclined plane, what will happen? So due to gravitational force, that ball should come down. Which means that ball should roll down to the ground. Am I right? Because gravity pulls the all object towards earth. Is it clear? Towards earth. So if we release the ball from top of the inclined plane, what will happen? Due to gravity, that ball should come. Am I right? Yes. So consider you are releasing the ball from the top. What will happen? Continuously the ball rolls down. Okay, continuously the ball will come down. The ball rolls down. Is it clear? Yes. So we get here. If you release the ball from the top of the inclined plane, that ball will come down due to gravity. Am I right? So before releasing, look at here. So before releasing, the ball was at rest. The ball was at rest. So initial velocity of the ball, how much? Initial velocity of the ball, zero. Initial velocity of the ball, zero. Is it clear? So if we release the ball, what will happen? If we release the ball velocity will increase. The ball velocity will increase. Is it clear? Yes. Okay, continuously the ball velocity will increase. So due to gravitational force. Am I right? Yes. So if you take any two points, is it clear? If you take any two points, here the car velocity will be equal. Which means the ball change in velocity will be equal. Is it clear?
If you listen here, if we release the ball, if we release the ball from the top of the inclined plane, velocity will increase. I mean, due to gravitational force, that ball should come down. So velocity of the ball will increase. Is it clear? Yes. So if you take any two points, in the motion of a ball, here the change in velocity will be equal. The change in velocity will be equal. Is it clear? Now consider, I'm going to give you example. Now consider, first question, this is one question, and each point there is question of the ball. Is it clear? Yes. Here, in first second, the ball velocity may have changed into 2 meters per second. Even next second also, the ball velocity may have changed into 4 meters per second. Even next second, the ball velocity may have changed into 6 meters per second. Even next second, the car velocity may have changed into 8 meters per second. Look at here. Consider the first two terms. First, initially the car velocity is 0. Then after 1 second, the car velocity increases to 2 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Now what is the change in velocity? 2 meters per second minus 0 meters per second, that is equal to 2 meters per second. Am I right? Yes. Next, leave that point. Now consider to this point. Next two points. Now the ball is here. Is it clear? Yes. So after 2 seconds, what is the car velocity? 4 meters per second. So already in this point, the car velocity 2 meters per second, and this point 4 meters per second. So 4 meters per second minus 2 meters per second, that is equal to 2 meters per second. And time remains same, that is second per second, which means per second. Is it clear? So whatever the point you take here, the change in velocity will be same. Is it clear? Change in velocity will be same. Is it clear? So that is example for uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. Here the ball velocity increases by equal amounts in equal interval of time. Is it clear? So that is example for uniform acceleration. Is it clear? What is the first example? The motion of a ball rolling down an inclined plane. Is it clear? Very simple. Next, second example, I'll give that. Next example, the motion of a freely falling object. The motion of the freely falling object. Second example for uniform acceleration. The motion of the freely falling object. You know what is freely falling object? Yes, let's get started. Look at here. Consider this is Earth's surface. This is Earth's surface. Consider a building. A building is there. This is Earth's surface. And that is a building. A building that is located, is present around the Earth's surface. Is it clear? Yes. Consider a boy. That boy is standing on the top of a building. Where? It's the top floor of the building. Is it clear? Yes. That boy has a stone. Like this. This is stone. That boy has a stone. Is it clear? Yes. Initially, the stone is at rest. So what is the initial velocity of the stone? That is zero. Initial velocity
0 meter per second.
Initial velocity of the stone, how much?
0.
Is it clear? Look at here. Consider this earth surface and there is a building on the earth surface. Is it clear? Yes. Next, a boy standing on the top of the building. Where top of the building? That boy has a stone. That boy has a stone. Initially, that stone is at rest. So, initial velocity of the stone, how much?
0.
Because displacement 0, if the displacement 0, initial velocity becomes 0. Is it clear?
Yes.
That boy going to drop a stone from the building, from the top of the building. Is it clear?
Yes.
Look at here. That boy drops the stone from the certain height of the earth surface. Is it clear? So what will happen? Due to gravity, that stone should come down. Am I right? Due to gravity, that stone should come down because earth pulls the all object towards the surface, which means towards its center. Is it clear? Towards its center, that is gravitational force. Okay. So if that boy releases the stone certain height from the earth's surface, what will happen? Due to gravitational force, that stone should come down. Am I right?
Yes.
The stone should come down. So these are the position of the stone. Is it clear?
Yes.
Initially, look at there. Initially, the stone is at rest. So initial velocity of the stone is 0. So then that boy releasing the stone from a certain height from the earth's surface, what will happen? Velocity increases. Am I right? So velocity of the stone increases. Is it clear? Initially the stone velocity is 0. When the boy drop the stone from certain height, velocity increases. Is it clear? Velocity increases. So this increasing velocity remains same. What is that? This increasing velocity remain same. So whatever the point you take here, increase, change in velocity will be same. Is it clear? The change in velocity will be same. So what about the acceleration here? What about the acceleration? Acceleration remains same. Is it clear? So that the g value 9.8 meter per second square. G value, okay, which means here g is nothing but here g is acceleration. Acceleration due to gravity, that's why I have mentioned g. So here, this acceleration value will be 9.8 meter per second square. That is acceleration, which means 9.8 meter per second divided by second. Here, that stone, look at here, that stone velocity changes how much? 9.8 meter per second. That is the meaning. Is it clear? So this is another one example. What is the second one? The motion of the freely falling object. Look at this, not only stone. So whatever the object you drop certain height from the earth's surface, the all object accelerated. Simply all object accelerated because here object velocity changes. So whenever the velocity changes, new term will occur, that is acceleration. That acceleration range 9.8 meter per second square. How much? 9.8 meter per second. What is it meaning, sir? Here the velocity of the object changes 9.8 meter per second. Per second, 9.8 meter per second velocity of the object changes. That is a meaning. You don't get confusion. Is it clear?
Yes.
Very, very simple. You don't get confusion. So next, so uniform acceleration completed. Next, non-uniform acceleration. What is that? Non-uniform acceleration. Next one, what is that? Non-uniform acceleration. Second one, what is that? That is non-uniform acceleration. See, this non-uniform acceleration actually directly is opposed to uniform acceleration. In uniform acceleration, the change in velocity that is equal. The change in velocity actually that is constant. But in non-uniform acceleration, that change in velocity is not equal. That is change continuously, that changing. Is it clear?
Yes.
Look at here. So what is already, what is acceleration? The change in velocity, that is acceleration. So here velocity of the object changes uniformly.
Is that?
Yeah, acceleration. We know already. We know acceleration. What is acceleration? It changes velocity. That is acceleration. So velocity of the object changes non-uniformly.
What is that?
Non-uniformly. That is non-uniform acceleration. Here, velocity changes non-uniformly.
What is that?
Non-uniformly.
Okay, that is called non-uniform acceleration. Let's get started. What is that? Okay.
Yes. First, consider straight through. Consider straight road. See, in this lesson, we need to imagine more.
Okay, so most of the physics concept we cannot show directly. We cannot show lively. Is it clear? Sometimes, especially in motion lesson, so we need to imagine. Is it clear? Imagination is very, very important in physics subject. Okay?
Yes. So consider straight road. Is it clear? That is straight road. The length of a road. The length of a road shows only one direction.
What is that? The length of a road shows only one direction. Is it clear?
Yes. So what is that? Then it becomes displacement. Okay. Then consider a car. Consider a car. Initially the car is at rest. The car is at rest. Is it clear? The car is at rest. Okay. Look at here, consider straight road and consider the car. That car is at rest. So initial velocity of the car how much?
Zero.
Initial velocity of the car, 0 meter per second, because the car is at rest. So if the car is at rest, the displacement power will be at zero. If the displacement zero, then velocity becomes zero. Okay?
So yes, consider.
This is point A. At point A, the car is at rest. So initial velocity of the car, zero. Okay, initial velocity of the car, zero. Okay, yes. Now consider, here the car starts moving. So gradually, the car velocity increases.
What is that?
Gradually, the car velocity increases. Is it clear?
Yes.
Next 15 seconds. Time how much? Next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes into 7 meters per second. How much? The car velocity changes, which means the car velocity increases to 7 meters per second from 0 meter per second. Is it clear? Very, very simple. Look at here. Consider this point A. At point A, the car is at rest. So initial velocity of the car is 0 meter per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Gradually the car starts moving, which means gradually the velocity of the car increases. Is it clear?
Yes.
Look at here. At 15 seconds, time how much? At 15 seconds, the car reaches the velocity of 7 meters per second. How much? 7 meters per second from the velocity of 0 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now the car comes to position B. Is it clear? So there is change in velocity. Because velocity of the car changes from 0 meters per second into 7 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Here, which is initial velocity and which is final velocity? Tell me that. See, 7 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 0 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right?
Yes.
So what is the change in velocity? The difference between the velocity, two velocities. So final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to change in velocity, already we know very well. Am I right? So 7 meters per second minus 0 meters per second, that is equal to 7 meters per second.
Yes.
The change in velocity how much? The change in velocity 7 meters per second. Okay, which means in 15 seconds, the velocity of the car changes into 7 meters per second. How much? 7 meters per second velocity changes in the rate of 15 second time. Is it clear?
Yes, very simple.
Now where is the car? Now the car is at position B. Where? At position B. Okay, which car is clear?
Is it clear?
Yes. So already what is the velocity of the car at point B? 7 meters per second. How much? 7 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
From the point B, now this point very important. From the point B, the velocity of the car increases. What is that? From the point B, so the velocity of the car increases next 15 seconds. Next 15 seconds. So already at P, at point B, time how much? 15 seconds. Next 15 seconds. So 15 plus 15, that is equal to 30. So next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 20 meters per second. 20 meters per second. Is it clear? Look at here. From the point B, next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 20 meters per second. What is that? 20 meters per second. Is it clear? Now answer this two term. Here, which is final velocity and which is initial velocity? 20 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 7 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right? So there is change in velocity. So that change in velocity, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. Okay, then we can get the difference velocity. Okay, which means change in velocity. Am I right? Yes. So 20 meters per second minus 7 meters per second, that is equal to how much? 30 meters per second. Am I right? That is equal to 30 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes, look at here. Next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes at the rate of how much? 30 meters per second. Is it clear? 30 meters per second. But in first 15 seconds, the car velocity changes how much rate? That is 7 meters per second. Next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes just 30 meters per second. Is it clear? 30 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Now, where is the car? Now the car is at position C. Consider this is C. Now the car is at position C. Is it clear? So already, what is the velocity of the car at position C? That is 20 meters per second. That is 20 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Look at here. Very important term. From the point C. What is that? From the point C, the velocity of the car again increases. From the point C, the velocity of the car increases. Is it clear?
Yes.
So, next 15 seconds. Next 15 seconds. So, 30, already 30 seconds is there. So, 30 seconds plus 15 seconds, that is 45 seconds. 45 seconds. Is it clear? Next 15 seconds, the car velocity increases to 30 meters per second. Is it clear? How much? Next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 30 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes, very, very simple. 30 meters per second. Is it clear? So, now the car comes to position D. Okay, so look at here. From the point C, again the car velocity changes. Okay, in equal time remains same, that is 50 meters per second. Is it clear? So car velocity changes to 30 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now consider these two terms. Here, what is the final velocity and what is initial velocity? 30 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 20 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right? So change in velocity, that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. Is it clear?
Yes.
So the 30 meters per second minus 20 meters per second, that is 10 meters per second. How much? The change in velocity, how much? From point C to point D, that is 10 meters per second. Is it clear? So what is the time, sir? What is the time? Time same. Look at here. So whatever the point you take, time value 15 seconds. Okay, then the difference between the two interval of time, that is 15 seconds. Here the difference between the two interval of time, that is 15 seconds. Is it clear? Look at here. At first 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 7 meters per second. Am I right? Even next 15 seconds, the car velocity increases at the rate of 30 meters per second. Even next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes at the rate of 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now come to this position. Now the car is at position D. Where? Position D. Here. Is it clear?
Yes.
Look at here, the very important point. From the point D. But from the point D, again the car velocity changes. Is it clear? So next 15 seconds. What is that? Even next 15 seconds. So already at the point D, what is the time? 40 seconds. So next 15 seconds. So 45 seconds plus 15 seconds is equal to 60 seconds. 60 seconds. Next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes to 50 meters per second. How much? 50 meters per second from the point D, not from the initial position. Look at here, from the point D. Is it clear? So already, what is the velocity of the car at the point D? That is 30 meters per second. Okay. So velocity of the car changes from the point D. So that into how much? 50 meters per second. Alright. So there is change in velocity. Alright. There is change in velocity here, which is final velocity, which is initial velocity. 50 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 30 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right? So final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to change in velocity. Am I right?
Yes.
So 50 meters per second minus 30 meters per second, that is equal to
20 meters per second.
20 meters per second. Is it clear? But what is the time difference, sir?
Time difference same. That is 15 seconds.
That is 15 seconds. Is it clear? So very, very important. Look at here. Consider a car. Inside the car, car is at rest position A. Is it clear? Then after 15 seconds, the car velocity changes into 7 meters per second from 0 meters per second. Is it clear? So the velocity of the car increases. Is it clear? So here 7 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 0 meters per second, that is initial velocity. So what is the change in velocity? So 7 meters per second minus 0 meters per second, which means final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to 7 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. Next, from the point B, again the car velocity changes. Okay, again the car velocity changes. So next 15 seconds, what is point? Next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes into 20 meters per second from the point B. So already, what is the velocity of the car? Car at position B, 7 meters per second. At position C, the car comes to 20 meters per second. What is the difference in velocity? So 20 meters per second minus 7 meters per second, which means final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to change in velocity. So that is 30 meters per second. Am I right? Yes. Now the car is at position C. So from the position C, again the car velocity changes to 30 meters per second. How much? 30 meters per second. Is it clear?
Yes.
So here, which is initial velocity, which is final velocity? 20 meters per second, that is initial velocity, and 30 meters per second, that is final velocity. So final velocity minus initial velocity, that is equal to change in velocity. How much the rate? That is 10 meters per second. 10 meters per second. Is it clear? Now comes to question C. This question, here the car is at position D. Already, what is the car velocity at position D? 30 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. So from the point D, again the car velocity increases. So next 15 seconds, the car velocity changes into 50 meters per second from 30 meters per second. Am I right? Here, which is final velocity, which is initial velocity? This is final velocity and this is initial velocity. So final velocity minus initial velocity is equal to change in velocity. Am I right? So 50 meters per second minus 30 meters per second, that is equal to 20 meters per second. Is it clear? Look at here. Now come to the content. It's very important one. Here the car velocity increases. Am I right? Here the car velocity increases by unequal amount. Look at here. Unequal amount, but in equal interval of time. Equal interval of time. Am I right? Yes. That is called non-uniform acceleration. Look at here. Here, the velocity of a car, okay, or any object. So velocity of an object increases by unequal amounts in equal interval of time. That is called non-uniform acceleration. Is it clear? That is called non-uniform acceleration. Time remains same. Time never changed. Time is constant. But during the particular time, the change in velocity is different. The object change in velocity is different. Is it clear, everyone? First, look at here. First 15 seconds, the change in velocity of the car, just 7 meters per second. Next 15 seconds, the change in velocity of the car, 30 meters per second. Next 15 seconds, the change in velocity of the car, 10 meters per second. Next 15 seconds, the change in velocity of the car, 20 meters per second. Is it clear? So the velocity of the car changes by unequal amount. What is point? Unequal amounts in equal interval of time. So that is called non-uniform acceleration. Is it clear? That is called non-uniform acceleration. So if a velocity of the object changes or increases by unequal amounts in equal interval of time, then the motion is called non-uniform acceleration. What is that? Non-uniform acceleration is a very, very important concept. Keep this to your mind. Is it clear? Keep it in your mind. Very, very important one. Is it clear? Look at here. Time same. Time remains same. 15 seconds, 15 seconds, 15 seconds, 15 seconds. But the velocity of the object changes. First one, 7 meter per second. Next 30. Next 10. Next one, 20. That is not equal. That is unequal. Is it clear? So that is called non-uniform motion. So whenever velocity of the object changes by unequal amounts in equal interval of time, then the motion is said to be non-uniform acceleration. What is that? Non-uniform acceleration. Very, very important one. Look at here. Is it clear? So in non-uniform acceleration, what about the acceleration values? Okay, so in uniform acceleration, the acceleration value will be same. Okay, whatever the time interval, the acceleration value will be same. But in non-uniform acceleration, here acceleration is not constant. Is it clear? Acceleration is here not constant. Here acceleration will be changing, because look at here. Here velocity changing is unequal amount. Is it clear? The velocity is unequal amount. So acceleration will not be equal here, which means will not be constant here. Okay. So next I'm going to solve that. You look at here. So this is velocity, then time, then acceleration. Velocity, time and acceleration. Okay, so now we are going to see, so what is the acceleration value? What is the acceleration value in non-uniform acceleration? Is it non-uniform acceleration? So whenever the velocity of the car, not car, object, so whenever velocity of the object changes unequal amounts in equal interval of time, here velocity will not be constant. Sorry, acceleration will not be constant. Acceleration is changing. Is it clear? Now I'm going to prove that. What is the velocity? Initial velocity 0 meter per second. Amare, then after that, what is the velocity of the car here? Velocity 7 meters per second. Amare, yes, 7 meters per second. And here velocity increases to 20 meters per second. And here velocity increases to 30 meters per second. And finally velocity increases to 50 meters per second. 50 meters per second. Amare, yes. Initially, what is the time? Initially, when the object at rest, what is the time here? Time 0. Time never 0. You consider that is nil, which means 0 also. Okay, you consider that. Imagine. Next one, what is the time here? First 15 seconds. Next one 30 seconds. 45 seconds. 60 seconds. 60 seconds. Is it clear? Yes, now I am going to find out the acceleration value. Look at here. So, A is equal to B minus 2 divided by T. A is equal to. Yes, I need some space. Look at here. So A that is equal to B minus U divided by T. So here also A that is equal to B minus U divided by T. A that is equal to B minus U divided by T. Here also A that is equal to B minus U divided by T. That's all. Look at here. Now I am going to prove. So in non-uniform acceleration, the acceleration value will not be same, which means will not be constant. Look at here. Here, first you take first two terms, this one and this one. Okay, initially the car starts from zero velocity, and after 50 seconds the car comes to what velocity? 7 meters per second. Is it clear? Yes. First you take two parts. Here, which is final velocity, which is initial velocity. 7 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 0 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Amare. So already we know acceleration that is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. Amare. Yes. Here, which is final velocity? 7 meters per second minus initial velocity 0 meters per second. Amare. 0 meters per second. That is equal to change in velocity. Amare. What is the time? Time 15 seconds. That is equal to what is the 7 meters per second divided by 15 seconds. Is it clear? You further divide both 7 divided by 15. 7 divided by 15, how much are you there? The smallest number, put one dot, add one zero, what will happen? 6. 6 into 15, that is equal to 60. Remaining 10, again add one zero, then 6.
sorry for that, not 6, 4, yes, 4 into 15 that is equal to 60, 4 into 50 that is equal to 60, and remaining 10, add 1 0, we can get 100, so 6 into 50 that is equal to 90. So what is the value? So what is the acceleration for first one? I'll write here because I don't have space. The acceleration value is 0.046 meter per second square. 0.46 meter per second square. That is the acceleration for first change in velocity. First two terms change in velocity. Is it clear? Yes. Next, I'm going to take next two terms. Next two terms, which means between point B and C. Is it clear? Point B and C. Here, what is the change in velocity? Look at here. So final velocity minus initial velocity. Which is final velocity? 20 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 7 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right?
Yes.
So 20 minus 7 divided by time, how much? Time same 15 seconds. Time same, that is 15 seconds. 15. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now what is the value? 20 minus 7, that is equal to 30, and 30 divided by 15, how much? You calculate further. 30 divided by 15. The smallest number, we don't add 0. Okay, then how much? Yes, 8. 8 into 15, 120. Remaining 10. And again add 0. And 6 into 15, 90. So what is the value here? 0.86 meter per second square. Look at here. In first two term. Okay, first two term, the acceleration of the car 0.46 meter per second square. Is it clear?
Yes.
Next two part, the acceleration of the car, how much? 0.86. What is that? 0.86 meter per second square. So here, the two acceleration, the acceleration is not equal here. Acceleration of the two terms of the car is not equal here. Am I right?
Yes.
Next, consider the next two terms. Next two terms, this is final velocity, this is initial velocity. 30 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 20 meters per second, that is initial velocity. Am I right? So final velocity minus initial velocity, 30 minus 20 divided by 15 seconds. Time interval, how much? Time interval same, that is 15 seconds. Is it clear?
Yes.
So 30 minus 20, that is equal to how much? That is equal to 10. So 10 divided by 15. 10 divided by 15, how much? 0. Add 0, then 6 is 90. Again 6, 90. Yes, what is the value here? 0.66 meter per second square. 0.66 meter per second square. So, look at here. So, at the point between C and D, the acceleration of the car, 0.66 meter per second square. 0.66 meter per second square. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now, consider the last two term. Here, which is final velocity, which is initial velocity. 50 meters per second, that is final velocity, and 30 meters per second, that is initial velocity. So final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time, that is acceleration. Am I right? So here 50 minus 30, that is equal to 20. Is it clear? So 50 minus 30 divided by time taken, 15 seconds. Time taken remains same, 15 seconds. Is it clear?
Yes.
So what is happening here? So look at here. So 20 divided by 15, how much? So 1, 15, remaining 5, put 1 dot, add 0, then 3, 45. So what is the value here? 1.3 meter per second square. 1.3 meter per second square. Here, look at here. So this is non-uniform acceleration. Am I right? So if non-uniform acceleration, here the velocity of the car changes unequal amount. What is that? Unequal amount in equal interval of time. Equal interval of time. So here the acceleration object is not constant here. So the acceleration of the object is not here, constant here. Look at here. In first two terms, okay, which means at the interval of first 15 seconds, the car acceleration is how much? 0.46 meter per second square.
is it clear? That is for first interval of 15 seconds, first time interval of 15 seconds. Next 15 second time interval, the car acceleration how much? Just 0.86 meter per second square. That is next 15 second time interval of next 15 second. Even next time interval of 15 second, the car acceleration that is 0.66 meter per second square. 0.66 meter per second square. Even last time interval of 15 second, the car acceleration that is 1.36 meter per second square. So look at here. Finally conclude that. In non-uniform acceleration, the acceleration of the object will not be same, will not be constant. Acceleration is continuously changing. Is it clear? Acceleration of the object continuously changing. Here the acceleration is not constant. That is a concern. Is it clear? So very, very important one. Is it clear? So don't get confusion. So this is example for non-uniform motion, non-uniform acceleration. Is it clear? So in non-uniform acceleration, here the object velocity changes unequal amount in equal interval of time. Is it clear? Yes. So in non-uniform acceleration, the acceleration of the object will not be same, which means will not be constant, that will be changing. Because here object velocity increases unequal amount in equal interval of time. That is the reason why. Is it clear? So very, very simple, don't get confusion. So example for this non-uniform acceleration, suppose you are driving a car in crowded area. What? In crowded area, can you maintain the constant speed? No, we cannot maintain the constant speed. Sometimes we need to reduce the speed, some night we need to increase the speed and so on. Is it clear? So due to which we cannot maintain the constant speed. So this non-uniform acceleration is possible when we are driving in a crowded area. Is it clear? So here acceleration will not be constant, acceleration will be changing. Is it clear? So very, very important one. So now we are end of this session. So in this session we have discussed so many things. First one, what is that? Uniform acceleration. Next, examples for uniform acceleration. And second one, non-uniform acceleration. And examples for non-uniform acceleration. Is it clear? So very, very simple, don't get confusion. So finally conclude that what is uniform acceleration. So uniform acceleration means nothing but, so when an object velocity changes equal amount, on this point very important, equal amounts in equal interval of time, then the motion is to be uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. So in uniform acceleration, the acceleration of the object will be constant. So whatever the time interval you take, the acceleration will be constant. Is that clear? Yes. So examples for uniform acceleration, what is that? First one, the motion of a ball rolling down an inclined plane, that is first one. And second one, the motion of a stone, most of any object freely falling. So that is example for uniform acceleration. Next one, the non-uniform acceleration. What is non-uniform acceleration? So when an object velocity changes unequal amount, want this point very important, unequal amounts in equal interval of time, then the motion is called non-uniform acceleration. What is that? Non-uniform acceleration. So very simple, very, very important, very simple. So in non-uniform acceleration, the acceleration of the object will not be equal, which means will not be constant. There will be change in acceleration because here the object velocity changes unequal amount, not equal. Is it unequal amount? So due to which the acceleration will not be constant, that will be changing. Is it clear? So very, very simple. The example for this non-uniform acceleration, so when you are driving in a crowded area, we cannot maintain the constant velocity. Sometimes we need to reduce the speed, sometimes we need to increase the speed. Is it clear? So that is example for this non-uniform acceleration. Is it clear? Yes, I hope this class will be useful for you. We will see next video class, and thank you.